Hello everyone, my name is Denis, and today we're going to talk about Sesen Bio with ticker SESN. I'm expecting huge volatility, and I think if you will buy put and calls, probably you will make some money. What exactly I bought you can find in my free Telegram channel, first link in the description down below. Sesen Bio own Vicineum, and it is a competitor for Merck Keytruda. And on this slide, you can see that Keytruda actually super good pharmaceutical for Merck. You can see that they're expecting for new FDA approvals for Keytruda in different cancer niches. And on this slide, you can see a 2020 total revenue from Keytruda, and it is $14 billion. And I think if SESN have something like this, it is definitely interesting to research. It is fresh June 4th, 2021 presentation. And here you can see a whole journey if you have blood in urine. And it can be not really good if you're 70 plus years old, because you have high chances for cancer. PDUFA date for BLA approval August 18th, 2021. And they're expecting for early commercial success in mid-2022. It is awesome. Also, they have European, China. Brand strategy, it is a best-in-class pharmaceutical. And it looks like they are. Peak global sales of $1 to $3 billion. On this slide, we can see market research, and I think they just talk with some urine guys. This slide can be a whole bullshit, because it is a little bit strange that 80% of participants will recommend Vicineum, because they don't actually see how it works. As they don't have their own facilities, they use Baxter and Cardinal Health to store it. And they will promote through urology clinics, and it is a plus, because if you promote via urology, you can catch your client really fast. They have over $100 million in their pockets, and I think it is awesome. They can survive maybe 1 year more easily. Over 400,000 new cases each year globally, and it is a huge market, and we already know that Merck making lots of money on something like this. Number six, bladder cancer. 81,000 estimated new cases only in the United States, and close to 20,000 deaths, and it is number six. It is very popular type of cancer, bladder. And the bladder, it is a place where your urine storage, and in women, removal of the entire bladder includes removal of the uterus, fallopian tubes, ovaries, and cervix, parts of the vaginal wall and surrounding tissue. In men, removal of the entire bladder includes removal of the prostate, seminal vesicles, and surrounding tissue. And this type of cancer are the worst, I think. Vicineum has two mechanisms of action. First, it is selectively targets EpCAM to destroy cancer cells by immunogenic cell death. And the second one, immunogenic cell death activates a T-cell mediated immune response to attack the tumor. And with the simple words, they have two components, and it is boost your immune system, and in 30% of cases you will just beat the cancer. Here how it look like, and on the left side you can see a tumor, on the right side after 4 weeks on treatment we don't see it, and it is definitely awesome, and it will be really hard for FDA to not approve this pharmaceutical. Here you can see FDA guidance, and it's quite interesting. They represent all of the data in five models, and it is a normal practice, I think. And first ding-ding bell that I don't really like, they collect some data and you can see products at the end of phase 3 approval 33%, products with BLA submission 82%, and Vicineum it is a BLA submission and it is 82% probability of approval. It looks strange. Very nice complete response rate, safety, everything looks really good. 40% complete response rate at 3 months, and it means that 40% go away without tumor, and I think it is awesome. Overall survival rate is 96% for 24 months. 43% of patients had a partial response and only 17% had no response. It is quite close to Keytruda, but in the United States, patients have a lower complete response rate. It is only 16% versus 29%. The second stage for the pharmaceutical, it is a head and neck cancer. It is quite big problem too. And if we will see approval, maybe they will approve in the future for head and neck cancer. Here you can see price reference, and I think it will be somewhere in the middle of $150,000 to $200,000. You wouldn't find anything interesting on Guru Focus because it is a late stage biotechnology company, but you can see that it is over $700 million in market cap, and it was close to $100 million a year ago. And now we will talk about what I'm expecting. I think they wouldn't get FDA approved because they are trying to show us that they will get it. And from my point of view, this strategy belongs to cheaters or something like this. And here is why. SESN Bio announced a new appointment to its board of directors, and they just hire someone from Pfizer for a lot of money, and it looks like they know something. And the other one, SESN Bio announced significant commercial progress as the company approached the potential approval and launch of Vicineum in the United States. And they just hire lots of people to sell their pharmaceutical, hiring of 25 talented internal employees to support the company cross-functionality, as well as the hiring 34 sales representatives as a part of a contact sales organization. And they will cover like 75% of urine professionals who actually treat these cancers. I think they will receive complete response letter, and then company will go to 1.5 or something like this, because it's a good point to fail. Or maybe I will wrong and they will get FDA approval. That is why I bought puts and calls, and we will see somewhere close to $8. It doesn't matter for me what will happen. If you like this video, please push the like button and subscribe button and leave some comment. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.